Good evening to all of you. Welcome to an evening with the Young Harris College Bands. I'm Dr. Hayes Bunch. I'm the director of bands here, and we're opening the program, obviously, with a little jazz, a little swing for you. And the tune you just heard was Robert Beasley's Next Up. Mr. Beasley is a trumpeter, a composer, an educator who is currently residing in Santa Fe, New Mexico, and as a performer, he's backed up a variety of touring artists, and he's a very versatile composer and arranger. Writes a high-quality music for jazz ensembles across a variety of levels, and he currently runs a private teaching studio out in Santa Fe, and also directs a jazz ensemble at the University of New Mexico. Next up, the tune again that you just heard was in a minor key. It's really kind of hard swinging piece in the style that's in the style of the famed Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. And this piece featured Ted Hopkins on the drums, who opened the piece, and then of course the kind of shifting little back and forth question and answer between the ensemble and the drums, and also featured soloist Mary Braun on marimba and Ella Casey on the alto saxophone, and so we applaud them. With a nod to back to October, which was just yesterday, and of course Hispanic Heritage Month, we celebrate the work next of Brazilian songwriter, composer, arranger, singer, pianist, guitarist, Antonio Carlos Jobim. And he was one of the great songwriters of the 20th century and is probably known best for his The Girl from Ipanema. And his work with jazz trumpeter Stan Getz is quite memorable, and so is his knack for the Latin style known as bossa nova. And Jobim's How Insensitive is sort of a velvety piece in the style of the bossa nova, and will feature Masira Carver on the flute for the pretty much the whole of the work, with a few solos again thrown in by Mary Braun on the vibraphone this time, and Ella Casey again on the alto saxophone. So please enjoy Jolene's How Insensitive. next number, Richard Rodgers broke new ground with his music for the American musical, mostly, and he makes the stories of plays and books and was a pioneer in the field of show business as a whole. And his tunes are memorable, and you will likely find yourself humming one of the two tunes of his that we're actually going to present tonight, the first of which is Have You Met Miss Jones? And it's an easy swing number that was written for the musical comedy I'd Rather Be Right in the late 1930s, and it's really light in character and a lot of fun, really. So please enjoy Richard Rodgers's Have You Met Miss Jones? Sarah Carver on the flute, and the piece was written in 1936 and was first brought to the public by Bob Hope and Eve Arden. And this again will feature a soloist Mary Braun on the vibraphone and also again Ella Casey on the alto saxophone. So please enjoy I Can't Get Started.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Ryan Fraley, composer of our next work, Prague Pacific, is another accomplished arranger, composer, producer, music engraver, engineer, etc. And his compositions and arrangements have been performed worldwide by a variety of jazz ensembles, orchestras, and concert bands of all levels. And Prague Pacific mixes progressive rock, so if you think the band Genesis from the 1970s before they kind of went mainstream pop on everyone in the 80s, which is still good stuff, by the way. So progressive rock and some funk as well, the style of music we know as funk music. And so you're going to hear sort of a halftime groove and these little melodic hooks that bring this chart really to life. And so we're going to feature soloist here, Mary Braun again on the marimba, and Ella Casey on the saxophone, alto saxophone. And so please enjoy Ryan Fraley's Prague Pacific.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Thanks again for being here and celebrating the spirit of music with us this evening. And we close the jazz band portion of our program with another Richard Rodgers' timeless pieces. And it's My Favorite Things from the 1965 film The Sound of Music, which a lot of you may be familiar with. And this tune has been covered by everyone from the great jazz saxophonist John Coltrane to current pop stars like Ariana Grande, even. The characters Maria and Mother Abbess join together in this number. In the movie, and refer to a bevy of their interests related to being an Australian child, as it is. And it's an uplifting little waltz that we hope you will be able to sort of enjoy, maybe give yourself a little smile. And we're going to feature a soloist again, Sarah Carver on the flute and Mary Brown on the microphone. So please enjoy Richard Rodgers' My Favorite Things from The Sound of Music. Thank you all so much. We're going to take just a short pause here, a little brief interval as noted in your program, to do a little bit of a set change, some housekeeping, and then we'll be right back with you with the Young Harris College Concert Band. So just give us a little patience and take a break there, and we'll be right back with you. So just a moment. Thanks for being here. while the band settles in, I wanted to come back and chat with you all a little bit, just tell you a little bit about the program, and I'm gonna talk about each piece before we play, just to give you a little background information and sort of prepare you for what you're getting ready to hear. And again, we thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules and the evening to come and again celebrate the great spirit of music here and the wonderful composers that we've chosen to share and explore with you this evening. So thanks again. The first piece that we're going to do, Joseph Turin's music covers a variety of genres, including film, theater, opera, orchestra, chamber music, jazz, even electronic and dance music. And he has been commissioned by really fine groups such as the New York Philharmonic and the Chamber Music Society of Lincoln Center. He is currently on the music faculty of Rutgers University, Montclair State University, and Keene University. And the work that we're going to share with you tonight, his Scarecrow Overture, is taken from Turin's chamber opera of 1976 called The Scarecrow. So we thought it would be fitting here on the heels of just right after Halloween, when we see all the pumpkins and scarecrows and the witches and all the things that celebrate that holiday, that we would do an overture that was based around the story of a scarecrow. And the basis of the opera is that it's a short story written by author Nathaniel Hawthorne, which you might know his best work, The Scarlet Letter. The scarecrow, his name is Feathertop, and he's brought to life, and in doing so, and entering the human race, if you will, sort of has to grapple with the idea of being human and all the things that go along with that. And this work is the overture to that chamber opera that was reworked in 2010, I believe, for Wind Ensemble and Concert Band. So we're going to feature that, we're going to present that tonight, and I think everyone's ready. So we appreciate your patience, and please enjoy Joseph Turin's Scarecrow Overture. photography, but it was basically a collection of curated photography taken from a variety of the different space shuttle missions. So that was going to be sort of a multimedia experiment coupled with Mr. Earp's brilliant writing in his score of space music. So tonight, you just get the sound, and you can imagine, if you will, the sort of the ether, the atmospheric kind of energy that you see when you see like pictures and film of space and the trips they've made up there. I mean, all going back to early days of the NASA program, but specifically the space shuttle mission and all the technology that's come about through their efforts. So we celebrate them tonight as well, and Mr. Earp's music, of course. Please enjoy Donald Earp's space music.
Thank you.
And while still a student, he composed and published in 1850 the original Fantasia for flute and piano, The Swiss Shepherd, which was also published in a version for solo piano. And the work is a theme variation kind of piece, so it moves back and forth in terms of the key, if you will. So you're going to hear some minor key and major key kind of going back and forth. And you're going to hear in the flute writing itself some pretty exciting technique, if you will, like the way that the flute is tongued, a double tongue, a triple tongue even. And this is demonstrated along with a series of brief cadenzas, like longer solos for the flutist, these kind of these runs and little interludes, and you hear with the band accompaniment, and it all makes it very exciting. And in this work tonight, we showcase senior music education major, Chloe Cantrell, as our flute soloist. So please welcome Chloe to the stage and enjoy Pietro Malachi's The Swiss Shepherd.
Thank you.
going to try to follow that best we can. Thank Chloe for her brilliant work and fine musicianship. And she just had a splendid senior recital last night. And a number of our students were able to attend, and it was really, really fine playing. So we applaud Chloe for her work, and she's off to the races next semester to student teach. And so, as they used to say when I was in school, we're throwing you to the wolves. So I make light of that, but we will miss Chloe in the ensemble setting. And so we're going to move on tonight in our program. And Hugh Stewart received his music education from the Oberlin Conservatory of Music, Columbia Teachers College, Rutgers University, and the University of Michigan. And he taught instrumental music in the schools of Maryland and New Jersey for 33 years. And Stewart wrote more than 100 published compositions. And Stewart said of his own piece, A Hymn for Band, he stated, "I have felt for some time that there was a need for a piece which, in addition to any aesthetic value it might have, could be used as a tool to help develop a better band sound through the performance of a legato style." So a very connected, sort of long, sustained kind of style of playing. And so with that, please enjoy Hugh Stewart's A Hymn for Band.
Thank you.
Midwest International Band and Orchestra Clinic, and by esteemed ensembles like the President's Own United States Marine Band. She is also the conductor of the Augsburg Concert Band at Augsburg University in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And Mary Shelley meets Frankenstein, imagines a scenario where the young author meets her own creation, a monster brought to life whom we colloquially refer to as Frankenstein. They meet, circling each other in a dance reflective of a tango, and Mary is initially curious and sympathetic while the creature pleads for compassion. In the moment when the two come together, Mary's sympathy is overwhelmed by horror, and she begins to panic, which the creature becomes furious with her rejection. And with the final notes, we are left asking ourselves, who is the real monster? So with that, we present a nice modern little take on tango and happy belated Halloween with Mary Shelley meets Frankenstein.
Thank you.
fun ride, and nice, interesting take on a classic story. Our last number of the evening is a classic for the concert band. Robert Jager studied at the University of Michigan as well, with William Ravelli and Elizabeth Green, before joining the U.S. Navy, where for 4 years he served as a staff arranger for the Armed Forces School of Music. And Jager taught at Old Dominion University and Tennessee Tech, where he was named Professor Emeritus. And Jager has over 150 published compositions and more than 35 compositions, including including once for the United States Marine Band, the President's Own, and the famed Tokyo Hosei Wind Orchestra. The third suite was written in 1965 for Mr. Leo Imperial, who was director of the Granby High School Band of Norfolk, Virginia, and dedicated these to him and his very fine organization there at the school. And the suite received its first performance by that school in December of 1965, and from Mr. Jager's own manuscript, and so it wasn't published quite yet. The first movement that you're going to hear is a march, which is is sort of altered rhythmically by the use of what we call a back and forth alternating time signature, 4 and then 3, 4 and then 3. And then the second movement is a waltz, which continues in this sort of time signature alteration idea, and features the oboe, the flute, the bassoon, and the brass section as well. And the closing movement is a really energetic rondo, and it's full of fun and bright little tunes which are developed really near the end, followed by a quick kind of ending coda section stating the main theme that you're gonna hear several times, presented by a variety of different instruments. So with that, we again appreciate you all so much for coming out and joining us this evening, and we're celebrating fall together, and we're closing the program with Robert Jager's third suite. Please enjoy. Thank you all again. Tonight, we hope to see you at future fine arts events. You check the back of your program for upcoming artistic venues, and we'll see you there. Thanks again. Have a lovely evening.